Hello, my name is Bill and welcome to Mind Your Crypto. Today we have TFUEL, but before we begin guys, of course if you want to have easy profits, then join buymeacoffee.com/mindyourcrypto, link is in the description down below. You will see how many benefits you will get and you will surely take profits from now on, even on a bearish market. Of course you can join our Telegram group chat where we discuss more and more about the crypto space and not only. So let's see now TFUEL guys. TFUEL is absolutely insane. Told you yesterday that we will probably be getting to 54 cents and then we need to just hold this bottom trend line. And that's what we are trying to do, guys. We are just trying to hold this bottom trend line. If we fall down from 54 cents, then the next support level sits at around 50 cents. Around there, guys, 50 to 51. So eventually, we want to hold this bottom trend line. TFUEL is very, very strong. The whole market crashes, guys, and TFUEL just goes insanely, does insanely good, guys. It just had a minor correction. Let's see the correction we had, around 10%, while the other market had almost 15-20%. Why is that, guys? Because TFUEL is outperforming Bitcoin. That's why we didn't just go so further down and lose our many support levels right here. So let's see now, guys, the MACD. The MACD on the 4-hour frame, we don't want to go beyond this level right here. If we go beyond this level, then we will lose a very, very significant amount of support levels, guys, because we want to make higher lows and higher highs. We want to keep having this pattern right here. Eventually, we need now a bullish recross between the blue line and the signal line, our orange line, right? We need to have a bullish recross, therefore we are good to go. And of course, we need to go above this resistance level right here. Okay, so we are fine, we stand fine, guys. This bearish cross is a very, very healthy correction. Let's go to TFUEL, guys, in Tether USD. You can see why we had the correction. We had the commodity channel index in an overbought situation. Now it is in an oversold situation, guys. You can see we are below minus 100. The RSI, though, sits at around 46, absolutely good, guys. And what we want to see now is to find the RSI, this bottom, and go even higher. Because eventually, guys, if we just stand above the support bottom trend line, then we are set to go, we are good to go. And of course, we can break afterwards the 62 cents. Right now, you can see the SL channel, the red line is above the grid line, so we don't have any buying opportunity yet according to this indicator right here. But you should always combine the indicators, guys. You have not so many indicators, right? You don't want to have like 100 indicators showing you what we will do, because eventually it gets confusing. You need to find your own indicators, your own technical analysis. You need to be expert, guys. So let's go to TFUEL USDT in the daily frame. In the daily frame, you can see that we had a buying opportunity here. And of course, for TFUEL, we don't have a selling opportunity yet according to the SSL hybrid indicator. So here we expect maybe to go upwards. Let's go to the Bollinger Bands, guys. And the Bollinger Bands, you can see that now we are below the top line and we are around in the middle, right? We are around in the middle right here. We don't have any risk involved according to the Bollinger Bands, because you already know, guys, when we are in the top line of the Bollinger Bands, we are having a risk. And you can see here that the commodity channel index, guys, was almost a little bit above the 100. Now we are going down, same here for the RSI, because the whole market, guys, is crashing, it's going down, right? Eventually, that's why now we are correcting a little bit. You can see the MACD, guys, you can see the MACD on the daily frame. For TFUEL, almost it is about to have a bearish cross. However, until we see that, we can't really say that we are in a bad position, right? We are having the blue line above the signal line, and of course we can see something like this getting rejected and then going upwards while the signal line gets more of a horizontal angle. All right, so it is very, very good. Now we have to go to TFUEL Bitcoin, guys. This is the reason that we don't just crash down all the way. And what we want to do now is to go to the 0.7 86. Finding support level on the 20-day EMA, keep going on the 20-day EMA as it goes upwards, and then go to the 0.786, still outperform Bitcoin, because you can see why we are correcting a little bit. We were above the 100 for TFUEL Bitcoin in the 4-hour frame chart. You can see here we were above 100, therefore we are correcting a little bit, but in overall you can see that we are starting to outperform Bitcoin. Yet after this correction right here, we are going all the way upwards. We want to break though the 0.786 Fibonacci retracement line. It is very, very important to retest afterwards the top, the previous top right here for TFUEL Bitcoin chart. The MACD, guys, is very, very good. We just don't want to hold to lose our support line here. We just need to see a bullish recross here and eventually surpass even this resistance line right here. So let's go on, guys, to the daily frame. On the daily frame, you can see we are battling to go above the 0.618. We want so much to go above this line right here, and then we will realize that we can eventually retest the 0.786. For now, 0.618, guys, our golden ratio is very, very strong. You can see on the daily frame, we are in an overbought situation, guys. So be careful a little bit. Same here, or not the same here, actually, for the RSI. We are near the 70, and you can see the MACD on the daily frame. Although we had a bearish close, we now have a bullish recross, but it is very, very likely that we might do something like this, right? And we want to avoid this. We want to avoid this because this reminds me, guys, of Matic Network. This pattern like here reminds me of Matic Network, where we had a bearish cross, then immediately a bullish recross, but then a bearish cross again, and we moved all the way downwards. So let's go to TFUEL, guys. You can see the bottom trend line. You can see that yesterday we advised you that we are going to 54 cents. You can see all that, and right now what we want to see is to hold this bottom trend line, and especially guys, the 54 cents, because if we don't do that, then we are actually going to 51 cents, 50 to 51 around there. Mark my words, guys, we will just be going here. We have one more minor support level though. In between these support levels we have the 52 cents, but I believe even if we go there, we will go soon to 50, 51. So always have it in your mind, guys, that we are in a little bear scenario, but TFUEL is holding amazingly good, right? It is holding amazingly good. And now don't forget that we are going into an oversold situation in the 4-hour frame for the commodity channel index. You can see here the RSI is not in an oversold situation. However, as I've advised you guys, you always check the commodity channel index first to see the RSI. And the MACD here, we lost our first support level, but we want to hold mostly this support bottom trend line right here. If we go down from there, then things aren't looking good for the MACD and in general for TFUEL against Tether USD, right? So we have to just go above the 54 cents and eventually keep having this bottom trend line. If we lose that, then we are going further down. And what is very, very crucial, guys, is the one that I tell you in all of my videos. Cross this target to go to the next. Go above the 62 cents, the 0.786 Fibonacci retracement level. You can see how important it is. We went upwards here, but we couldn't close. You can see this candle. We couldn't close above. Therefore, break this target to go to the next. And you know our next target is the 80 to 81 cents. But of course, we might retest the high, the previous high before, because right here, you can see, guys, we won't just surpass the 0.786. Afterwards, we have the 68 cents. And of course, we have our next price target. We might find correction a little bit here and then go to 80 to 81 cents. So Bitcoin, guys, where is Bitcoin? How is Bitcoin doing? We are in an oversold situation. As I've told you guys here to be careful, now I'm telling you that we might see a reversal pattern soon, right? And as we can see that if Bitcoin goes upwards, then TFUEL will be ready to explode, because if we keep outperforming Bitcoin, guys, if we keep outperforming Bitcoin and not correct, because it is very crucial, guys, as Bitcoin goes upwards, we need TFUEL to always outperform Bitcoin, not to correct against Bitcoin, because afterwards we can't go to the 62 cents and surpass it, right? We need to see a strong TFUEL against Bitcoin and a strong Bitcoin. And you can see now on the Komod channel index, we are going below minus 100. The MACD guy is about to have a bearish close right here, but we will see about that. We might get rejected, we might not. We will see what we will do here, guys. It is almost upon the signal line. The blue line is almost upon the signal line. You can see on the 4-hour frame, guys, for Bitcoin, we almost hit the 30 level, but for the Komodo channel index, we were way in an oversold situation. So we have a very, very oversold situation, guys, on the daily frame. We might close even above the 33,800. If we do that, guys, if we close above this level right here, it is actually very, very good, right? It is actually good for Bitcoin, and we are in an oversold situation. Therefore, what we want to see for TFUEL, first of all, holding the support line, especially the 54 cents, right? We want to hold the 54 cents. Secondly, of course, when we break the 62 cents, guys, we are ready to skyrocket, right? We are ready to skyrocket. We have the 3.0 mainnet launch coming on 30 June. You already know that. I already repeat that many times in the videos. And guys, of course, before we end here, don't forget to join our Telegram group chat. And of course, our monthly subscription to get easy profits. Links are in the description down below. Thank you for watching. Have a fantastic day wherever you are. See you soon with many, many more videos. Bye.